Jay Shrek, Miss Legends and Lies, and today I'm on the east side of Cave Creek, Arizona, at a place called the Sears-Kay Ruins. And it's supposed to be a nice mild hike of about a mile. The trip out here was completely paved, and so far it's been just an easy, pleasant day today. And this loop is supposed to be about 1 mile. What we expect to see are some Indian ruins, and we're still close into town. From above, I can still see houses, so we don't seem like we're way out. It's supposed to be a great mild hike, so come along. Let's see what we see out here, and we'll get into a little bit of the history today of what it's like to hike Indian ruins close to town. Now, a lot of these structures have been restabilized, so a lot of these aren't the original structure, the way they were. They've been rebuilt, let's put it that way, and that's why they look as good as they do. For some wall that had been here for, 900 years, it's pretty incredible to think that they could still be here. Now, one of the things to think about when you're looking at these structures also was that the lintel, which is the crossbrock or wood that goes across the very top of the doorway, and then the jamb, and then the sill, which we still call sills today. So basically right here was the jamb would be right here, the rocks here. The lintel would be across the top to be able to hold the roofing section up. And then the jamb, which would be on the bottom, we still say that today. Isn't that amazing? You look at these structures. These are fairly sociable people. I mean, they had to live up on this hill by them, with the whole group. And so one thing that I'm intrigued about is the fact that, they built this. I want to call this a fort, because they had to defend themselves. And even though they had to make sure that there wasn't people around them, it was going to get them. Wow, we made it to the top, and I tell you what, it was really a nice hike. Really pretty simple. It'd be a hike that I'd say, if grandma and grandpa come in from Omaha and want to see some Indian ruins, but don't really want to hike, and you still want to stay somewhat in town. If you look out here, the first thing you realize is the reason they build up here, right? So let's take a look around. Now, as you can see, that's the reason they built up here, is because it was a place that they could defend. A lot of times what happens is we want to think that the conflicts happen only when the settlers came. And we don't want to realize that, it was been survival in this land for 1,200 years. Everybody was trying to survive. And so if there was another tribe that was low on food, or maybe had to move because of water, they might come over and try to assault you. So they built defensive forts. So this is basically a fort. That's why it's on the top of this ridge. Now, they're always going to be close to water, and they were farmers, but they also had to defend this location. Now, one of the rooms that's really interesting is everything else here is square. So let's take a look at all the other structures basically are square. Like a regular house would be today. So each one of these walls, like basic construction today, square corners. So the first thing you might ask if you came down here is, well, why is this room here have round walls? that is kind of funny because everything else is square. Now, there's a couple thought processes of why maybe this was a round room. Now, one of the thoughts are is that this could have been a different civilization that constructed differently. Because one thing we have to realize too is that all of these ruins eventually were abandoned because of, well, what would be reasons why some of these places would become abandoned, right? Water, drought. Eventually, you know, if you're here 200 years, they were in this location for about 200 years. What would happen is that, you know, eventually the game would run out. There could be a drought. So they had to be mobile to a certain degree also. So a lot of these ruins that you see today all over this area, because there's ruins all the way through here. The first thing they were looking for was water and then a defensible position to be safe. Now up here also, when they constructed this mountaintop, they built walls, retaining walls, then actually leveled out the top ground to give them more room. And so this was a defensible position. And pretty incredible to see that this stuff's still here. It really is. These walls are spectacular. So real quick, one thing when you get on any of these sites and you see an Indian ruin, you know, all of a sudden it just throws in a whole storm of controversy of, you know, don't tell where it's at, don't, you know, let's keep it a secret. And, you know, I've got my thoughts on that. You know, again, most people that would be watching me are not the kind of people that would vandalize. They'd be the opposite. They're going to be the people that are going to appreciate history, want to save history. They're not going to be the people that are going to vandalize. The people that are going to vandalize, they're not watching this, right? That's not so, you know, I also think that thinking you can hide something forever, I mean, is ridiculous. So how do you save these places? I think, you know, you educate. You tell people how important this is, that we hold on to our heritages, our history. I think that people, when they know where they're at, they actually respect them more than them being secret. And you know, you have these people that want to say, well, I am the only one that knows where this is at. You know, vandals are going to vandalize. You know, one thing that we have noticed in our journeys all over this great Southwest is that when you look at a lot of the graffiti, it's our grandfathers, it's our uncles. I hate to say that, and I hope it wasn't mine, but you know, 1906, 1910. And for some reason, if it's an 1890, that's cool. But if it's a 1970, that sucks. And I'm not making a decision of what's better or not, but you know, everybody's one to mark on the walls. I mean, if you want to think about it realistically, you know, the first form of graffiti was petroglyphs. I mean, however we want to look at that. So I believe it's through education that we can save these places, not through, you know, we're always going to have vandals. We're always going to, I mean, we're always going to have that. But I think that if we educate and that we show how cool this stuff is and it becomes something that's really neat, all of a sudden that, you know, we can have people enjoy their history and their culture. Are we going to have people vandalize? Yeah, we always have. We're not going to stop that. And you know what? I just think through education and showing people how important it is that we hold on to our past instead of getting rid of it, I think it's going to allow us to be able to keep these places, you know, sacred. Because I believe that's what they are. I mean, it's awesome to me to be sitting on this rock, 1,000 to 1,200 AD, 900 roughly years ago. Somebody else is sitting on this very rock, looking out, you know, pondering their life and their history and their, you know, how their life was going to end up being. let's talk about the Sears-Kay Ruin here from 1050 to 1200 AD. The Hohokam, which the ancient ones, that's what the name implied. It was about a half a mile to the top. Really a nice hike, well taken care of. Very interesting place. Great place to be able to do a hike from. I thought it was very intriguing. And today there's no one here, but it is a Friday. And half mile bathroom facilities, all paved all the way out here. You know, so if you want a nice easy hike, something a little different in town, don't have to get prepared, don't have to load up all the stuff, just to come out and have just a nice day. You know, a great place. You're in Cave Creek, you want to spend maybe a couple hours out here. Beautiful area, just lovely. Good information, the way they laid it out was really neat. Really pleased with how the whole structure is and the documentation and the effort they've done to make this really a pretty cool place and someplace that we ought to all make sure that we take care of. I definitely rate this high. I'm considering this in town an awesome place to go, and everybody should. Chase Wreck, Myths, Legends, and Lies at the Sears-Kay Ruins, right outside of Cave Creek, Arizona. You gotta come see it.